story is begins in Nepal. I was a journalist and I was walking through the hills of Nepal when I came across rows of villages which didn't have girls from age 15 to 45. This was 18 years ago. And I began to ask the men who were sitting there drinking tea, playing cards, where the girls were. And some were hostile, some walked away, but a few answered. And they said, "Don't you know, they all are in Bombay." And I couldn't understand how so many girls could be in Bombay. Bombay was 1,400 kilometers away. These villages were 2 hours away from the highway. So as a good journalist, I began to look for the answer, and the answer changed my life. Because when I went into the village, I found that the flesh trade existed in my lifetime, in my generation, in my country. There was a smooth supply chain from that little village to the brothels of Bombay, Delhi, and Calcutta. There would be a procurer who could be an uncle, a neighbor, a brother, who would go to a poor starving farmer and say, "I will get your daughter a job in the big city," or even say he would put her into prostitution. But he would say, "She will get some money, she will get food, she will get a bed." And the farmer didn't know anything about the realities of prostitution. He would let his daughter go. These girls were between the ages of 9 and 13. And the farmer would get $100, $150 for his daughter. This person would cluster together 3 or 4 girls in the big cities of Kathmandu and Biratnagar and take them down to the border of India and Nepal. There was the corrupt border guard, wink, wink, nod, nod. The girl was taken across the border. On the other side were the lodge keepers who would lock up these little girls for 2 days, 3 days, beat them, starve them, drug them, till their spirits were completely subjugated. And when they were ready to do anything, they were handed over to another set of transporters. These transporters would then put them in trains, buses, trucks, and take them to the brothels of Bombay or Calcutta or Delhi. And there were the pimps who would negotiate the price depending on their beauty. Now by beauty, I mean fair skin was at a premium. The younger, the better. The youngest girl I've met is a 7-year-old. She wasn't even menstruating. Ice was used to break her. Voluptuous, docile, because all this was demanded by the customers, the clients, the johns who came to buy girls in these brothels. And then the pimps would hand over these girls to brothel managers who would lock up the girls for the next 5 years and bring them out for 8 or 10 customers every night to be raped commercially. And then when these girls were completely chewed up, they were spit out because they were no longer commercially viable and told, "Now you can keep what you earn," by which time they could not earn anything. Mm-hmm. Prostitution is one occupation where you earn less as you gain more experience.